Have you ever dealt with unstructured data? Well, imagine having to process millions of retail product descriptions in real time and making sense of it. This is a video on how DoorDash used large language model to transform its retail catalog management to automatically extract and categorize product information at an unprecedented scale. Let's dive right in. When DoorDash decided to expand beyond restaurant deliveries, they encountered a new challenge, managing a wide variety of product information. Each item is presented by a list of product attributes known as stock keeping unit, or SKU. For instance, these Coca-Cola cans and these Pepsi would have different SKUs. To provide the best experience, DoorDash needed high quality attributes for each product. Think of it as the difference between simply saying Coke versus Coca-Cola original flavor 12-ounce fluid can pack of 12. These detailed attributes are crucial for three reasons. They help customers find exactly what they wanted, improving their experience. They enable delivery drivers to locate the right items more efficiently. They allow for more personalized recommendations and promotions. But with millions of products to manage, manually handling these data was not scalable. When DoorDash onboarded a new merchant, they faced a significant challenge: integrating the merchant's product data into their retail catalog. The data often came in various formats with missing or incorrect information. To address this, DoorDash implemented a process called SKU Enrichment. This involves standardizing and enhancing the raw merchant data to ensure accurate product attributes for each SKU. However, this process was outsourced to contract operators who had to perform the task manually. Not only was it costly, but it was also susceptible to errors. DoorDash soon realized that this manual approach was not sustainable for the long term. They needed an automated solution that could handle the scale and complexity of their expanding catalog. This is where machine learning came into play. What DoorDash wanted was an extraction tagging model like token classifier. A token classifier works by breaking down the contacts like Dove Silk Glow Body Wash 500mm into individual word known as token. It then assigns a label or category to each token. In this example, Dove would be the brand, 500 is the size, and ml is the size unit. However, building an in-house attribute extraction model requires extensive amount of training data to reach good accuracy. This is referred to as cold start problem in natural language processing, where a significant amount of label training data are required to build an accurate model from scratch, and I thought that Lambda's cold start was cumbersome. They decided to utilize large language models, which are deep learning models trained on vast amount of data. These models can perform natural language processing tasks with reasonable accuracy without requiring many, if any, label examples. They implemented this in various projects, including brand extraction and organic product labeling. Brands are crucial for distinguishing products and enhancing features like sponsor ads and product affinity. The new large language model pipeline uses a multi-step approach. First, given an SKU data, an in-house brand classifier attempts to identify the brand. For SKUs that cannot be confidently tagged, it would be passed to another large language model for brand extraction. A second large language model then checks for similar brand in an internal knowledge graph to avoid duplicates. If it doesn't exist, new brands are added to the knowledge graph, and the in-house classifier is retrained. This large language model power system allows DoorDash to proactively identify new brands at scale, significantly improving both the efficiency and accuracy of brand ingestion. They also develop a model to label organic grocery products, aiming to enhance personalized discovery experiences for customers. The process starts with a single string matching, looking for exact mention of the word organic in the product titles. While this method offers high precision, it misses cases where misspellings or alternative presentations exist. To address these issues, DoorDash employed large language models to determine whether a product is organic based on available product information. This information can be provided by the merchant directly or extracted using optical character recognition from packaging photos. For a product where the large language model is not confident in, they use a large language model agent that can conduct online searches to retrieve the product information and pass the findings back to another large language model for reasoning. There was still another issue to tackle, which is determining whether two SKUs refer to the same underlying product. This process is called entity resolution. This is a hard problem because it requires accurate extraction of all application attributes for each product, which varies across different product categories. Yes, we use bags for our milk in Canada. prime wishes he can get some of these milk.
Oh my goodness, I can't quit.
To overcome the limitation of having few human-generated annotations, they leverage large language model and retrieval augmented generation to accelerate the labeling process. Retrieval augmented generation is a technique that combines the strength of information retrieval and generative language models. It first retrieves the relevant document or data from its knowledge base based on a query, then uses a generative model to produce coherent and contextually accurate response. It then uses OpenAI embeddings to represent SKUs as vectors of floating point numbers in order to find related product. This is done using approximate nearest neighbor. When a query comes in, the algorithm only searches within the most relevant group from their golden annotation sets. This aims to trade accuracy for significant speed improvement. These golden annotation sets are then fed to GPT-4 as context to generate labels for unannotated SKUs. This method of selecting similar examples reduces the likelihood of hallucination in the large language model outputs. In the future, DoorDash is exploring multimodal large language models to process both text and images for attribute extraction, addressing limitations of text-only approaches. They're experimenting with visual QA and chat plus OCR and building infrastructure for Dash to take product pictures for direct attribute extraction. What do you think of their approach? I think it's really cool that large language models are so integrated into their system. I hope that you get to learn something new today, and as always, thank you so much for watching and see you next time.